Hello and welcome back to Marwell again. So, last time we bailed the headlands up on the grass field, today we need to get them wrapped. Or should I say in this video, so we're on the same day as when we bailed them. Won't leave them sitting out unwrapped for too long. So we're back on the end series now. I've just popped the loader on this to come with this straw bale. It's a bit annoying. Could be more annoying trying to pick some of these bales up on here, unfortunately. Let's get that unfolded. Some of these ones in the corners could be incredibly awkward for us. Fastest job in the world, unfortunately. See how we can get this one now. Right near fence post of all places. Swing round in there for that one. Let's just check our deed, see if we own this field, because that might be a good place to put a straw barn up. We have to have all these bales sitting in the yard. At least we know they ain't gonna roll away off the wrapper. So we'll swing around and get that one near the hedge. Yeah, we've got 42 of them to wrap up on here. I'll keep us going for a little while. I won't record all of them being wrapped up. I don't want you falling asleep on me. So I'm going to swing around and get that one now. So those who are wondering why we stack them on the end like this, it's because the wrap is thicker on the end, so the crows can't get their beaks through it so easily to puncture it. That then causes the bales to go mouldy and solid. Stand on the round, the wrap is a bit thinner. Birds can get the beaks through it too easily, unfortunately. We need to get this done so we can get back onto the barley. At least the fire jets are quieting down a bit now to what they were earlier. Seem to be fairly well grouped in pairs around here anyway. Trying not to drop any on the stuff we haven't raked up yet. I have a feeling we'll have to probably clear these up before we can do that anyway. A lot of them to do on here yet, so we'll be here a little while. So I shall carry on doing these And you can rejoin me again once we've got a little bit further with them. So I'll see you in what'll be a few minutes for yourselves, a little while longer for myself doing these. Welcome back. We're down to our last two bales now. It's taken us nearly 25 minutes to get this far. That'll be all 42 bales wrapped up then. A slow and steady process, but we're there now. Clear these up so we can actually rake the rest of the field up. We don't want to hit these with the rake as we turn on the headlands or the baler. And split the wrap up on them after spending all this time doing this. Luckily the auto load trial will handle the rat bales as well, which is good. The rest of this field isn't quite ready to bale yet, unfortunately. That will give us time just to get these cleared up. So I'll drop this on the field as we will be needing it again. Moment anyway. Just going to pick the auto load trailer up. So we might actually drop these bales in that hard area next to the field there. This takes 8 at a time, so 4 loads should get 32 of them. 5 loads will get 40 of them, so we should be making progress by then. Let's head back up, try and get realigned for that one. Trouble is, they're still a little bit close in places. Haven't really got space in the yard for these at the moment. Or sensible space anyway. Down now. Just wondering how much space there is in that little area when we come into the field. Fairly close to the yard there, then if we do decide to have a straw barn put up, they would be in the way. It's fairly level in this little corner here. go over the side of the barrel that there is because of the pickup arm. It's our first date. Turn back, work around the field this way. Nice quick job clearing these up with this. Quicker than using the squeeze on the loader. It's more the risk of the barrels getting damaged this way, but speed helps at the moment with how much work we've got on. Come off this field by the time we've finished. I think we'll need to worry about the next cup. Probably sell that for the ID plant. We'll just track across the cut grass here rather than all the way around the outside. Doing a great amount of harm. Make our way back up from this corner then. That old straw one up on the way back. Let's put the loader on just for that one barrel. Just got the fence of that picker arm on the side, unfortunately. Try and do is aim for these to sit in the gap between the two if we can. Straight back there somewhere, I would have thought. Next lot beside them. Just build ourselves a nice stack in this corner. Hopefully we'll fall over. Just got a big mess on the hands there. Space to give the trailer a chance to keep up a bit easier. Two more after this one. Two trailers as well. That's an odd one, of course. Always an odd one when you don't know one. Nice little track for this one for doing this sort of thing. Good size horsepower wise, but small enough to be maneuverable still. Doing these jobs. Be alright using one of the bigger ones for it. It's not quite as maneuverable into tight space as this tractor is. About there somewhere. I'll keep working across diagonally like that. So the next ones will sit in the gap between the first and second and third barrels, and the next load after that will go in the gap between the third and fourth row of barrels there, down to the outside edge again. So I should keep our cows fed for a little while. At the moment, but another day or two they'll need some more. Just feed the sows a bit earlier than I'd like them to start eating it. I want to try and let the middle of the field dry out a bit more. Quick, keep torn with the other day of doing haylage instead of silage at the moment. Let the grass almost get to hay stage before we pile it up and wrap up. So by now that there should be one more full trailer. Then a odd two bales. Should be 10 bales left on here, plus the straw one. The other two silage bales I'll probably take straight back to the yard. I'll put in our stack and mess things up. I'll actually just leave them on the field for now. It's probably a better idea. That's how it goes to that straw one, really. Causes too many problems sitting there by itself. It's out of the way down this corner anyway. Needs to be on both the houses down here, so no one's going to complain about these barrels being an eyesore. See, this is the only colour wrap they had when we went to buy some, so we couldn't get black this time. Nice lot of barrels we had on this farm, we bought in the black ones. Try and line it up in there again. Trial and error job. bit too far over to the manor. Just bring it back this way a bit. Keep it as neat as possible in here. There'll be a lot more barrels to come down here yet, off this field. Stag as tight as possible as well. Might be a little bit too far back that time. Hope it hasn't knocked anything over. Next one to just go to our right as we're facing the stack. Or left as you sit in the tractor. Eight more barrels, the other two can stay there then. Until we've done the rest of the field. I'm not going to turn too much on that top headland anyway, so there shouldn't be a big problem up there. Think about getting back on with our combine pretty soon. We need some straw bales as well. They will have to come back down to the yard. So we find out how good my math skills were. So we should get two more on here. There's only one spare barrel, I mean I miscounted, there's only 41. That's 40 on there, plus an odd one there. So that means there's 42 in total. But only 41 silage bales. Unless I've missed one somewhere as we've been collecting them. I don't think I have. No, so 41 silage bales, plus one straw. It's a slight miscounting on my part when we were baling them. There's 40 barrels all in the stack down this corner. What will be when this load goes in. So there isn't too many, but I'll also have a problem getting the wrap out next time. Have to move it. Jets are back by the sounds of it. A nice tidy stack started in the corner here. Four high is plenty for these. Same goes for the next rows. We'll go on, we'll keep going diagonals across there like that. Leave this trailer in this corner as well. we'll be needing it on here again. Makes sense to run it back up to the grindstone. We need to get that right back on. So we're going to start by raking up the longer end up the other, the longer work up the other end of the field. That's the plan. Nice long ends done first. We'll see how we're getting on from that point onwards with everything. Let's get that turned on. And go straight through here. Longest ends on the field up there. He was going for a little while. That's good swath coming out now. Guess there's going to be over 100 barrels off this field easily. Really be enough to keep the cows fed for a few weeks. I shall now carry on raking this up, and that's where we'll leave this video. So join me again next time where we'll see how far we've got. Probably we've got this field barrel by then. Hopefully get so we can get back on with the combine again. So I hope you've enjoyed this video, and if you have, please remember to drop me a like, and I will see you next time. Goodbye for now.